Hey guys, it's the Going Crown here, and today I'm going to be showing you, let's just move the mirror out of frame, there we go. I'm going to be showing you my everyday Halloween makeup look, or in my terms, everyday for the whole year round, but it's Halloween, so I had to put Halloween in the title, because why not? Also, do you like my flower crown? Probably can't see it very well. Do the flower crown? There we go. Isn't it pretty? All of this was just done with like everyday makeup products except for part of the eyeliner, which was done with fake blood. I got this one at Claire's like years and years ago, but you can use literally anything. Because I like the colour and also get a little bit Halloween-y in there. Just gonna take you to the tutorial now. Have fun. Hello, might have just told you this. I need to not look at you, not the viewfinder, okay. Need to get used to this. I might have just told you this, but I have a new camera, which is why I'm a little bit confused. So if anything goes weird, that is why I'm trying. I don't even know what I'm going to use this camera for. If it's going to be for makeup videos, if it's going to be for vlogging things. I don't know. We'll find out. I'll do a review when I know a little bit more. So bear with the temptation to look at viewfinder instead of the filmy bit, the lens, is killing me right now. So I'm sorry. I'm trying. Also fisheye, not sure how I feel about the fisheye yet. Don't know how it's gonna work for makeup-y things. If I zoom in, is it gonna let me know? Well, let me zoom in while I'm filming. It looks like really weird, so I don't know. So we'll see. Let me know if you like the fisheye or not down below. And I can turn it off, because I can turn it off. So I turn it off, dance. Let's actually do what you came here for now.
I'm just spraying a base coat on. This is Urban Decay, but I'm not gonna specify that you need to use any of the products in this video because the chances of having them all are really, really small. And then I'm using a moisturizer as a base, and it also works as a good primer. The Body Shop one, I would recommend it. Then I'm just putting my foundation as normal on with a sponge, and then this is powder foundation, and then I am using my finger to get it around my eyes so that I have even coverage. I would recommend using a slightly paler foundation just because you know you want to go for the slightly dead Halloween look, but this is already very, very close to the palest that they do. So just gonna roll with that. Then I'm taking a translucent powder. These are usually actually white, so it is gonna sort of make you slightly paler. It's not gonna make you darker anyway. And just taking a powder brush and dusting that all over my face to set the foundation, but also hopefully make me slightly paler. Then I'm just priming my eyes before I put colour on them, because you know, dark colours aren't gonna last very long unless you prime. Then I'm taking a brown, which is slightly darker than I would usually use to fill in my eyebrows, because I wanted to do black, but it would have looked a bit weird, so brown will do. I need to actually tell you how to do this as well instead of just talking. Take a angled brush and just fill in your eyebrows like normal. If you don't know how to do this, there's 1,000 tutorials out there. Just do it like you do with a pencil, but with a brush instead. Angled brush though. And then using a smoky grey colour and an eyeshadow brush, I'm putting it all over my lid. I'm not blending too far up because with darker colours that'll happen when you use a blending brush anyway. So I'm just following the shape of my eye and just colouring that bit in. And then I'm just taking a blending brush and blending the crease. It should just go upwards anyway, but if you want to blend it upwards, go for it. You know, it's your life, your eye. I don't know what your eye looks like. And then I'm taking a darker brush, and rather than going for the crease, which you would usually and an eyeshadow brush, and rather than going from the crease or the side, which you would usually do, I'm going from the very, very bottom of your eye as close to the lash line as you can get, and going upwards from there. And I'm just taking a black pencil eyeliner and lining my tight line, and looking a little bit crazy as I do it. I was gonna say a little bit Alexis-ist, but that doesn't work because my name's not Lex. And then I'm just doing my waterline, which looks a little bit less crazy, but not like totally sane. But that's fine, because like I'm not, this channel's not, you're probably not, to be honest. And then I'm taking a felt liner and doing winged eyeliner. Honestly, good luck for this. One day I might make a tutorial on how to do it, but I just usually just wing it. See what I did there? Just wing it. Subscribe for more quality puns. Then I'm taking some fake blood and a detail brush. If you want this to be darker, you can use actual eyeliner or body paint, but I wanted this to be more subtle. Would not advise putting this on your eyes, however, it did hurt a little bit, but you know, I'm here to make the mistakes. I'm taking Fitbit Digital Brush and I am going over the eyeliner just like slightly above where I did it before to create like a double winged effect. You can't see it very well, but I promise you can see it in real life. And then when everything's dry, curl your eyelashes, but make sure everything's dry because it will go everywhere otherwise. I learned this the hard way. And then I'm just using an intense volume mascara because I didn't want to put fake eyelashes on in case my eyes watered and then fake blood was everywhere. Which might be a cool look actually, but you know, we're going for subtle. And then I'm lining my lips with a purple. I didn't have the exact shade of lipstick, but I know close enough, right? So it's chill. And then finish off with lipstick, which of course has to be the darkest purple you can find. Wanted to go black, but you know what? I'm preferring a purple. And then I'm just combing my hair back, sticking a bit of hairspray in it, and sort of poofing it a bit. And then of course, adding a flower crown, because no look is complete without a flower crown. They make everything better.
Hope you enjoyed that. If you have any requests or questions, then leave them in the comments. You can find me at all of the addresses that will be in the description. And also, check out the like thing at the top of the links, because Ben, my friend, sends me like, hello phone. It was from Tilly. You guys know who Tilly is by now, right? Unless you're actually Tilly, you're probably Tilly. Hi Tilly. The top bit is Ben sending me like promos for things that he's gotten. You can get like money off and it's good for him, it's good for you, so meh, check them out. They change every now and again, so I'm not going to tell you what it is because it's different, but have a look there. That should be there. That would be cool of you to do. I hope that's helpful. Don't think I have anything else to say. Yep, new videos every Wednesday. Guess I should probably say that, unless it's not next Wednesday. Maybe I don't. Maybe this is... Ooh, which reminds me. When this video goes up, it'll have been last week. I think it might be today, actually. I think it's today that I'm filming this on. I've officially posted a video every Wednesday for a year. I think I mentioned that in the last video, but I think it's today. Hello, please stop. My phone hasn't buzzed for like an hour for the entirety of like the time it told me to do this. It didn't take me an hour, but you know. And now as soon as I'm talking, it buzzes. Anyway, I'm gonna go now because I've got things to do in my life and you're probably sick of me talking now. Right.